Thank you, Ray.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
How'd you get started writing songs? Because I was very impressed with all of your writing. How did you get started doing that?
I was singing a lot of songs, all kinds of different songs, you know, like all of us from the time I was, you know, just a little boy. And I started out, didn't really know if I wanted to sing rock and roll or sing folk music or what, because all that stuff was around in the 50s, the late 50s. Yeah. And got to the point where I knew so many songs, but none of them would exactly say what I wanted to say. So I tried to write a song, and I think one of the first songs I wrote was "And I Love You So," which ended up becoming a
big song, yeah.
A song for a lot of people. And what I tried to do was write a song that was like an old-fashioned song, like I had heard on the radio, a pop song, you know, like I would hear, you know, Bing Crosby or somebody sing. I always loved those melodies, and so even though, you know, it was the 1960s and everybody was against everything that old people liked, you know, I really liked popular music and the beautiful melodies, and so I ended up fusing the old style with the rock and roll that I could understand, which was, you know, Buddy Holly and Elvis Presley, simple songs with folk music. So a lot of my stuff, you know, have lyrics that are a little bit more than normal, but they have a chorus, you know. And
well, you can tell. I can hear that in your song. Have you recorded in Nashville?
Well, that's the funny thing. I started recording, the first album I did was in Berkeley, California, in the middle of the riots. In 1969, and the next time I was in New York, I said, I'm going to be closer to home now. I don't want to be out in California. I loved it, and I really did love it, but I said, you know, I want to be closer to where I live. So I made the next record, American Pie, and three more in a place called the Record Plant.
I remember that.
In New York City. And then, you know, I got tired of everybody taking forever to get a sound.
Yeah.
You know, they take forever to get a bass sound. I said, come on, you know, I mean, it costs money. You know,
turn the mic on.
And it took forever.
That's it.
So I was encouraged to come out and record with Larry Butler in 1978. And that was a transition of my life because I walked into the Nashville studio and there were the Jordanaires and Bob Moore and Pete Drake and all these legends. And they were so nice to me because I was, you know, nothing compared to them. And here I walked in there, and everything was perfect. The playback sounded better than the records that I was making.
Oh, gosh.
And
I can vouch for that. My first session, I met those same guys, and they made me feel great.
Yeah. And so the playback sounded so good. I said, oh, my God, this is heaven, you know, because I don't have to deal with a week trying to get the drums to sound right. They had it all together, and they still do. The band is sounding tremendous. A lot of these guys I've worked with.
Well, speaking of the band, you brought a couple of musicians that play with you now.
Yeah.
With you that used to, well, one of them used to play in my band.
Jerry Croon.
Jerry Croon, the drummer. And he's the guy. Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's hear it for Jerry. He's the guy that played the drums on my record of Misty.
Long, long time ago, I can still remember how that music used to make me smile. And I knew if I had my chance, that I could make those people dance. Maybe they'd be happy for a while. But February made me shiver with every paper I'd deliver. Bad news on the doorstep. I couldn't take one more step. I can't remember if I cried when I read about his widowed bride. But something touched me deep inside the day the music died. So bye-bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys are drinking whiskey and rye, singing this'll be the day that I die. This'll be the day that I die. Did you write the book of love? Do you have faith in God above? If if the Bible tells you so. Now, do you believe in rock and roll? Can music save your mortal soul? And can you teach me how to dance real slow? Well, I know that you're in love with him, 'cause I saw you dancing in the gym. You both kicked off your shoes. I dig those rhythm and blues. I was a lonely teenage bronkin' buck with a pink carnation and a pickup truck. But I knew I was out of love the day the music died. Started singing, bye bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys are drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this'll be the day that I die. This'll be the day that I die. Now for 10 years we've been on our own. Moss grows fat on a rolling stone, but that's not how it used to be. Why, when the jester sang for the king and queen in a coat he borrowed from James Dean, and a voice that came from you and me. Oh, and while the king was looking down, the jester stole his thorny crown. Courtroom was adjourned, no verdict was returned. And while Lennon read a book on Marx, a quartet practiced in the park. We sang dirges in the dark the day the music died. Oh, sing it with me. Started singing, bye bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys are drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this'll be the day that I die. This'll be the day that I die. Helter skelter in the summer swelter, the birds flew off with a fallout shell. 8 miles high and falling. Landed foul on the grass. Players tried for a forward pass with the jester on the sidelines in a cab. Now the halftime air was sweet perfume while the sergeants played their marching tune. We all got up to dance. We never got the chance. Players tried to take the field. Marching band refused to yield. Do you recall what was revealed today? The music died. We started singing, bye bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys are drinking whiskey and rye, saying, this'll be the day that I die. The day that I died. Oh, and there we were all in one place. A generation lost in space, with no time left to start again. So come on, Jack, be nimble. Jack, be quick. Jack Flash sat on his candlestick. Fire is the devil's only friend. Oh, and as I watched him on the stage, my hands were clenched in fists of rage. No angel born in hell could break that Satan's spell. As the flames climbed high into the night to light the sacrificial rite, I saw Satan laughing with delight the day the music died. And he was singing, bye bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys are drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this'll be the day that I die. This'll be the day that I die. Well, I met a girl who sang the blues, and I asked her for some happy news. but she just smiled and turned away. And I went down to the sacred store where I'd heard the music years before, but the man there said the music wouldn't play. In the streets, the children screamed, the lovers cried, and the poets dreamed, but not a word was spoken. The church bells all were broken, and the three men I admire most, the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, they caught the last train for the coast. The day the music died, and they were singing, "Bye, bye, Miss American Pie." Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys are drinking whiskey and rye, singing, "This'll be the day that I die. This'll be the day that I die." Okay, sing it with me now. Here we go. They were singing,